So hello everyone and welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs. In today's session guys, I will bring to you some more important questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. And guys, NABARD ka bhi phase 1 hua hai recently and main khud bhi gaya tha paper dene just to see ki how is the paper. So the paper guys was very very easy, I must say bahut aasan paper tha. So agar kisi ne PIB 247 और जो गवर्नमेंट स्कीम के सेशन हमने किए हुए हैं यूट्यूब पे, अगर उनको किसी ने रिलीजियसली फॉलो किया हुआ है देन डेफिनेटली आई कैन गारंटी कि 40 में से 35 के आसपास क्वेश्चन कोई भी आराम से अटेम्प्ट कर सकता है. और जो 5 क्वेश्चंस का मैं विंडो दे रहा हूँ वो भी इसलिए दे रहा हूँ क्योंकि 100% की गारंटी नहीं लेनी चाहिए. सो 40 में से 35 क्वेश्चन बहुत ईजिली टैकल किए जा सकते थे इफ़ यू हैव कवर्ड दीज PIB सेशंस एंड गवर्नमेंट स्कीम सेशन प्रॉपरली. सो अब जो फेज 2 आने ही वाला है, फेज 2 की ऑल दो डेट नहीं है अभी तक, सो फेज 2 का डेट का इंतजार मत करो, लेट्स स्टार्ट प्रिपेयरिंग. फेज 2 की जो प्रिपरेशन है वो स्टार्ट कर दो, चाहे आपका कैसा भी पेपर दिया हो प्रिपरेशन स्टार्ट कर दो. अच्छा गया है खराब गया है यू नेवर नो कि आपका रिजल्ट क्या आएगा और क्या नहीं आएगा. ऑलराइट, यू नेवर नो दैट व्हाट विल बी द कट ऑफ, यू नेवर नो कितने सारे लोगों का जो एग्जाम हुआ है वो कैसा गया है. ऑलराइट, सो इन सब चक्करों में मत पड़ो कि कितने आ रहे हैं कितने नहीं आ रहे हैं, उसके कितने आ रहे हैं उसके कितने आ रहे हैं, इन सब चक्करों में मत पड़ो. जस्ट फोकस ऑन योर प्रिपरेशन. अगर आपको ऐसा हो सकता है, ऐसा कई बार हुआ है, मेरे साथ भी कई बार हुआ है कि हमें लगता है कि कुछ सर्टेन एग्जाम्स में कि अब तो हमारा नहीं होगा, बट हो जाता है. ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स नॉट वेट फॉर द एग्जाम डेट्स, लेट्स स्टार्ट द प्रिपरेशन फ्रॉम टुडे इटसेल्फ. एंड आई होप आप में से कई लोगों ने प्रिपरेशन स्टार्ट कर दी होगी, तो प्रिपरेशन करते रहो. एंड इन टुडे सेशन आई विल ब्रिंग टू यू सम मोर क्वेश्चंस एज यूजुअली फ्रॉम द PIB न्यूज. और हाँ, और जो फेज 2 है उसके लिए भी जो PIB के सेशन है वो अभी तक जब तक एग्जाम डेट होगी उसके एक हफ्ते पहले तक के भी क्वेश्चंस आ सकते हैं, तो PIB के सेशन अभी भी आपके लिए इंपॉर्टेंट है. सो प्लीज डोंट इग्नोर दिस सेशन. सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन गाइज, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन डू सब्सक्राइब टू द चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन इफ यू आर कमिंग हियर फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम. And you can join this Telegram group. Iska link you will find in the description. And here you will get the PDF of this session. And you can also follow me here. This is my Instagram ID. You can also ask any doubt here. यहाँ पे कभी कभी doubt बताने में थोड़ा सा late हो जाता है. But yes, आज तक कोई भी ऐसा student नहीं है जिसको मैं doubt ना बताए. एक दो दिन कभी कभी हो जाते हैं. And in some cases तो मैं within hours reply कर देता हूँ. So please, अगर late हो जाए, delay हो जाए तो please बुरा मत मानो. और यहाँ पे भी आप मेरे से डाउट पूछ सकते हो, तो डाउट पूछने के लिए बहुत सारे डोर्स हैं आपके पास, बस डाउट पूछो आप. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन विच सेज द मेघालय एंटरप्राइज आर्किटेक्चर प्रोजेक्ट लॉन्च्ड बाय यूनियन मिनिस्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड आईटी, एंड हु इज द मिनिस्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड आईटी? अश्विनी वैष्णव एंड ही इज ऑल्सो ऑफकोर्स द मिनिस्टर ऑफ रेलवेज मिनिस्टर भी हैं ये. Is based on 6 pillars. Which of the following is not one of the 6 pillars? This project, Meghalaya Enterprise Architecture Project, has been launched by Union Minister of Electronics and IT, which is based on 6 pillars. So the question is, which of the following is not one of those 6 pillars? Alright, so let's talk about this news. So remember, the Union Minister of Electronics and IT and Meghalaya Chief Minister Conrad Sangma. Who is Meghalaya Chief Minister Conrad Sangma? They both have launched this project, which in short is known as Megha. और उसका पूरा नाम क्या है? मेघालय एंटरप्राइज आर्किटेक्चर प्रोजेक्ट. एंड दिस प्रोजेक्ट गाइस हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड टू इंप्रूव द सर्विस डिलीवरी एंड गवर्नेंस फॉर द पीपल हु आर यूजिंग डिजिटल टेक्नोलॉजीज. जो लोग डिजिटल टेक्नोलॉजी का इस्तेमाल करते हैं, जो एंटरप्राइजेस डिजिटल टेक्नोलॉजी के ऊपर बेस्ड है पूरी, उनको सपोर्ट दिलाने के लिए टू सपोर्ट दोज एंटरप्राइजेस हु आर वर्किंग ओनली ऑन द डिजिटल टेक्नोलॉजीज, दिस project has been launched. And do remember that this project has been launched under India, and this is not in INDIA, it is INDEA, which is India Enterprise Architecture. And this India Enterprise Architecture project was launched in the year 2018, and under this project this Megha has been launched. All right, now this Megha is based on 6 pillars. And which are these 6 pillars guys? These are governance, human resources, entrepreneurship, primary sector, infrastructure and environment. And the total fund which is allocated for this particular project guys is rupees 5 crores. Do remember the funds also. And there are various projects which are under implementation under this project. So 5 crore ka total fund abhi tak isko allocate hua hai. Now moving ahead to INDEA, India ke bare mein baat kare, so it was launched in the year 2018 and it was formed after a after the recommendations of a committee which was headed by Mr. J. Satyanarayana. You remember the name of this person? J. Satyanarayana was the chairperson of that committee which recommended the formation of India. Now, why was India formed? Iska objective kya tha? Ye kyun banaya gaya? Aise hi bana diya gaya? Koi to reason hoga. Of course, the reason was to document and share explicit and implicit architecture best practices. Architecture se related best practices share karne ke liye, logo ko batane ke liye, this was formed. And also to provide guidance in the development of enterprise architecture. Ek enterprise ka architecture kis tarike se hona chahiye, ek enterprise ke andar kya kya basic cheeze honi chahiye, uska ek pura architecture provide karane ke liye this India was formed on the recommendation of a committee which was headed by Mr. J. Satyanarayana in the year 2018. All right. So this was about this news, guys, and now let's come back to the question. And which of the following is not one of the six pillars? Governance, human resource, primary sector, infrastructure, education is not one among them. So option E will be the correct answer. And talking more about Meghalaya, so Chief Minister, you all know, is Conrad Sangma. And Conrad Sangma's party is National People's Party. And who is the governor? Satyapal Malik. Satyapal Malik. Meghalaya was formed in the year 1972 mein form hua tha. And of course the capital is Shillong. Capital kya hai iska? Shillong hai. And talking more about Meghalaya, so there are various famous festivals, like we have Bedian Kalam. Bedian Kalam is the very famous festival of Meghalaya. And also Nong Krem. Nong Krem is the very famous festival of Meghalaya. Alright, and you will find very famous Balfakram National Park in Meghalaya. You will also find Nokrek National Park in Meghalaya. So there are various things that you have to remember about Meghalaya. And this national park brings me to the 53rd Tiger Reserve of India. Recently it has been announced that Guru Ghasidas National Park will be the 53rd Tiger Reserve of India. Now can you tell me which tiger reserve are which are the 52nd and 53rd tiger reserve, 52nd and 51st? Can you tell me which are the 51st and 52nd tiger reserve of the country? It was recently announced that jo 51 aur 52 number ye tiger reserve hai, recently announced kiye gaye the in the year 2021 only. Before 2021 we have only 50 tiger reserve, but now we will have 53. So 51st and 52 are already there. 53 Guru Ghasidas National Park will be there soon. Okay, and where is this Guru Ghasidas National Park? It is in Chhattisgarh, of course. It is in Chhattisgarh. Okay, let me tell you the name of 52nd. It is Srivillipattur Meghmalai. It is quite difficult, so let me tell you this. Srivillipattur Meghmalai, which is in Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu. Now you have to tell me the name of 51st Tiger Reserve of India. So here the correct answer is education, guys. Now let's move ahead to question number 2. Consider the following statements with respect to Vishveswarya PhD scheme and you have to identify the correct statement. Now the question first of all is why we are discussing about Vishveswarya PhD scheme. So first of all, this is the question, why are we studying this? So we are studying this because its phase 2 has been launched by Ministry of Electronics and IT. The phase 2 of Vishveswarya PhD scheme has been launched by Ministry of Electronics and IT. And why this phase 2 has been launched? To promote research in 42 emerging technologies in 2 sectors. And which are these 2 sectors? These are electronic system design and manufacturing and IT enabled services. These are the 2 sectors in which the number of PhDs will be enhanced under the second phase of Vishveswarya PhD scheme. Now we have to go into somewhat deep about this scheme. So this scheme, guys, remember, was launched in the year 2014 by Ministry of Electronics and IT. And please don't confuse, it is not Ministry of Education, it is not Ministry of Skill Development, it is Ministry of Electronics and IT which launched this scheme in the year 2014. And the objective was to enhance the number of PhD in these 2 sectors, ESDM and IT enabled services. And of course during the first phase, 63 global patents were registered. Jo pehla phase abhi tak tha, usme 63 global patents register ho chuke hain. And this is the financial support which is being provided under this particular scheme, Vishveswarya PhD scheme. Kya kya hai, dekh lete hain. For full time PhD fellowship is how much? 38750 per month for first 2 years. Alright. And from 3rd to 5th year, it is 43750 per month. And annual contingency grant support, rupees 30,000 per month, is being provided to the full-time PhDs. Now, what about the part-time PhDs? So the part-time PhDs are getting only one-time incentive under this particular scheme, which is ₹2,50,000 on successful completion of PhD. So they will get this amount after completion of PhD only. All right. What about young faculty research fellowship? So they are getting fellowship of ₹20,000 per month and a research grant of ₹5,00,000 per annum for maximum period of 5 years. 5 साल से ज्यादा नहीं मिलेगा. ये नहीं कि PhD लगे हुए 10 साल तक करे जा रहे हो, ऐसा नहीं होगा. एंड दीज आर द टारगेट्स ऑफ फेज टू स्कीम. फेज टू स्कीम के टारगेट्स हैं, चार टारगेट्स हैं. 1,000 फुल टाइम PhD कैंडिडेट्स का टारगेट है, देन 150 पार्ट टाइम PhD कैंडिडेट्स, देन वी हैव 50 यंग फैकल्टी रिसर्च फेलोशिप एंड अ न्यू टारगेट ऑफ 225 पोस्ट डॉक्टरल फेलोशिप्स ऑल्सो. सो अंडर द फेज टू द पोस्ट डॉक्टरल फेलोशिप्स विल ऑल्सो बी प्रोवाइडेड. ऑलराइट गाइस, so this was about this news and now let's come back to the question. The scheme was launched in 2014 by Ministry of Education. So is that Ministry of Education? No, that's Ministry of Electronics and IT, MeitY. In phase 1, 63 patents have been published. Yes, this is absolutely correct. The second phase is targeted at 1000 full-time PhDs. Absolutely correct. One-time investment of ₹4,50,000 on successful completion of PhD is provided to part-time PhDs. It is not 4,50,000, it is 2,50,000. 2,50,000 रुपए का incentive मिलता है किनको? Part-time PhD वालों को. So this is incorrect. Second and third will be the correct, which means option D will be the correct answer, guys. Option D. Alright, option D will be the correct answer. I hope, guys, this question is clear. And now let's move ahead to question number 3. Which of the following organizations has launched Planetarium Innovation Challenge for Indian Startups and Tech Entrepreneurs? Indian Startups or Tech Entrepreneurs ke liye Planetarium Innovation Challenge. Yes, Planetarium Innovation Challenge has been launched. So the question is, which organization has launched this? So remember, guys, this has been launched by MyGov. MyGov. So MyGov has launched Planetarium Innovation Challenge. And what is the objective? To bring together all the Indian startups and tech firms to build an indigenous planetarium system software. Indigenous planetarium system software, basically software banaya jayega related to planetarium using various technologies like AR, VR and MR. What is AR? Augmented reality, virtual reality and merged reality. All right. And the participant can be any startup, any Indian entity, any individual or any team, and the prizes are this: first winner 5 lakh, second winner 3 lakh, and third winner is 2 lakh. Now these things are not important, just these are for the basic understanding that what they are doing under this particular project or the challenge. The important thing for exam is which organization has launched this and what is the name of the challenge. That is it. All right, so now let's come back to the question. This has been launched by MyGov. So option B is the correct answer, MyGov. Moving ahead to question number 4. How much amount of grant has been released for non-million plus cities? Now, which are these non-million plus cities? So remember, the 15th Finance Commission. The 15th Finance Commission has divided urban local bodies into two parts, which are million plus cities with population more than million. And this is non-million plus. The second is non-million plus cities, the population less than 1 million, non-million plus cities. Million plus cities, population million or more, 1 million or more. And non-million plus cities are those which have population less than 1 million. Okay. So this question is regarding non-million plus cities for their basic expenditure and for strengthening the delivery of basic services by the Ministry of Finance. So this has been launched by Ministry of Finance for non-million plus cities. Let's talk about this news. The amount is being asked in the question. The amount, guys, is 2,427 crores. 2,427 crores, and this amount is for urban local bodies across 11 states of the country. 11 states across the country, and you need not remember the name of these 11 states because ye aage bhi auron ko milenge to wo dheere dheere karke sare states aur UTs mein aa jayega. So that is not important. And this grant, remember, this grant has been provided for non-million plus cities. For what is the objective? Non-million plus cities karenge kya iska? So they will use this amount for their basic expenditure and also for strengthening the delivery of basic services. Apne yahan pe jo basic services hai usko uski delivery ko improve karne ke liye, and for the basic expenditure this amount, this grant has been provided. And as I told you that 15th Finance Commission divides ULBs into two parts, million plus urban cities and non-million plus urban cities. And जो ये non-million plus urban cities को grant मिलता है, this is divided into two parts. The grant which is being provided to non-million plus cities is divided into two parts. Number one is the basic grants, or you can say the untied grants. Basic grants or untied grants. ये basic grants का मतलब क्या है? बेसिक ग्रांट्स का मतलब यहाँ पे ये है फॉर लोकेशन स्पेसिफिक नीड्स एक्सेप्ट द सैलरी. कोई भी नीड, बस सैलरी नहीं होना चाहिए, उसके अलावा कोई भी चीज के लिए पैसा वही वाला यूज हुआ हो सकता है, बेसिक ग्रांट वाला, जिसको वी ऑल्सो से वी ऑल्सो नोन, इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज अनटाइड ग्रांट्स. नाउ व्हाट अबाउट द टाइड ग्रांट्स? दिस इज फॉर सपोर्टिंग एंड स्ट्रेंथनिंग द डिलीवरी ऑफ सर्विसेज. ओके, दिस इज फॉर सपोर्टिंग एंड स्ट्रेंथनिंग द डिलीवरी ऑफ सर्विसेज. एंड आउट ऑफ द टाइड ग्रांट्स, out of the tied grants, two parts are also there. 50% of the tied grants will be used for sanitation solid waste management, sanitation solid waste management and attainment of 5-star ratings as developed by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Okay, let me repeat this. There are two types of grants provided to the non-million plus cities. One is the basic grants, where location specific needs, with the help of which location specific needs are fulfilled except the salary. All right, then we have tied grants, which is for supporting and strengthening the basic service delivery. Okay, and this tied grants are divided into two parts. Number one, 50% will be used for solid waste management and attainment of the star rating, which is being developed by which has been developed by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. And the rest 50% will be used for drinking water, rainwater harvesting and water recycling. So I hope guys there is no confusion here. So this was about this news guys, and remember, who is the chairperson of 15th Finance Commission? Yes, 15th Finance Commission, who is the chairperson? N.K. Singh is the chairperson of 15th Finance Commission, and he has been recently appointed as the chairperson of Institute of Economic Growth. Institute of Economic Growth का इनको चेयरपर्सन बनाया गया रिसेंटली. एंड दिस इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ सिंस 1992 द चेयरपर्सन वॉज डॉक्टर मनमोहन सिंह. एंड रिसेंटली मिस्टर एन के सिंह हैज रिटन इट्स हिज ऑटोबायोग्राफी विच इज नोन एज पोर्ट्रे ऑफ पावर, पोर्ट्रेज ऑफ पावर. ऑलराइट, सो नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. 2427 करोड़ इज द करेक्ट आंसर गाइस टू दिस क्वेश्चन, ऑप्शन ए. Moving ahead to question number 5, which is the last question for today. Which of the following drives has been launched by Department of Justice and NALSA to mainstream legal aid? Now, can you tell me the full form of NALSA? Write down in the comments the full form of NALSA. और अगर नहीं पता है तो कोई बात नहीं, नाराज मत होना. कुछ स्टूडेंट्स नाराज हो जाते हैं कि हमें नहीं पता होता, फिर भी आप पूछते रहते हो, बताते नहीं. नहीं पता है तो आप कमेंट में ये लिख दो कि नहीं पता, कोई बात नहीं. डोंट फील कि आपकी इंसल्ट हो गई. ऐसा कोई भी इंसान नहीं है इस दुनिया में जिसे सब कुछ पता है. मेरे को भी नहीं पता, किसी को भी नहीं पता. तो प्लीज डोंट गेट फील कि हमारी इंसल्ट हो जाएगी अगर हम कमेंट में ऐसे लिख देंगे, तो ऐसा कुछ नहीं होता. तो विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग ड्राइव्स हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जस्टिस. एंड ऑफ कोर्स डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जस्टिस इज अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ लॉ एंड जस्टिस, विच इज हेडेड बाय मिस्टर किरण रिजिजू. किरण रिजिजू लोकसभा कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी अरुणाचल वेस्ट. अरुणाचल वेस्ट इज द लोकसभा कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी. तो The name of the campaign guys is Ek Pehel. Ek Pehel drive has been launched by Department of Justice and NALSA, and this has been done to mainstream the legal aid and to actualize the aspiration of access of justice to every citizen of the country. All right, and these are some key points about this drive. Like, it will continue, it will start from 17 September up to 2nd October 2021. There will be deployment of 185 mobile vans and other vehicles to showcase films and documentaries on access to justice. And these are some basic things that you can read from the PDF. These are not important for the exam, of course. Just remember that it will start from 17 September and it will end on 2nd October. And the name of the campaign and which department has launched this, along with which agency. Agency is NALSA, department is Department of Justice. The name of the campaign is Ek Pehel. Therefore, guys, the correct answer is what? Oh, Ek Pehel to option mein nahi hai. Okay, let's make this option as Ek Pehel. Alright, so option E, Ek Pehel. Let us say that option E is Ek Pehel. Main Ek Pehel hi option mein nahi dal paya, sorry. Ek Pehel is the correct answer. And guys, that's it for the session today. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. And milte hain Friday ke session mein. Thank you so much for watching. All the best for the NABARD Phase 2 and the upcoming NABARD, upcoming RBI Grade B exam. And so many students are asking that RBI Grade B ka notification kab aayega. So see, hame bhi nahi pata ki kab aayega. But yes, agar aap, matlab agar main ek andaze se bataun, to in my opinion, in the first 3 months of 2022, January, February, March, kabhi bhi aa sakta hai. So let us again, let me appeal this thing in front of you that let us not wait for the notification. Notification mein wait mat karo, padhna shuru kar do yaar. Theek hai, jab notification aayega tab padhoge, to fir wahi phadbadahat mein cheeze hongi, aate hue cheezon ko galat karke aaoge exam mein, to wo achhi baat nahi. Alright, thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care and God bless.